most physical men in WWE today. Cesaro and Sheamus will start this match. John, I want to ask you point blank strategy for the first two men who start the chamber.
Survive. That's all you can do. Look, you can't win this thing right off the bat, but you certainly can lose it right off the bat. You have to be there at the end. Simply survive. Crawl out, grab the rope, whatever you have to do, survive.
And another way to look at this, guys, is if Cesaro or Sheamus could put one another away real quickly, they'd get some, well, breathing room before the next guy's released.
JBO, you've been in there. Let me ask you, are they in the most dangerous part of this chamber right
there
now?
There's not one doubt about it. That is solid steel. Nothing outside that ring gives at all.
Yeah, nothing breaks your fall. Right in front of Randy Orton, Sheamus goes to work on Cesaro, Orton the reigning WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Wow, what an uppercut. This is gonna be physical.
You know, John, in your chamber match, you actually started the match inside the pod as Sheamus lands on the steel. When you're inside the pod, what is your mentality? How do you keep yourself ready when you're not quite sure when you're gonna enter this match?
Well, you're just standing there. You wonder about it. Are you gonna stand there too long where you don't get loose anymore? Where you come out of your goal, and all of a sudden you walk out there, you walk on a steel, and somebody's attacking you.
Cover. And again, you know, we talked a lot about how the last person into the match could have the advantage. Maybe they don't, however, because they're tight. They're not.
That's a great point, Michael. The last person stands there and watches all the action for many minutes.
Sheamus cover here on Cesaro and a kick out.
And whether they were loose or warmed up when they came out here, they're not after they've sat in that pod for some time.
The number five entry has been the entry that has produced the most winners over the years. Five winners from the number five position, including Triple H three times. In fact, Triple H has four wins in the Elimination Chamber.
Look
more
out
than anyone as Cesaro hits the steel hard.
He's wishing for those knee pads right now. The best thing that could happen to either Cesaro or Sheamus right now is to get a pinfall, get a victory over your opponent before your next superstar enters, right?
Yeah, because it's 5-minute intervals, you might just have a little bit of time.
You're not kidding.
Now this hurts whether you're in the chamber or not. Good grief. Listen to that. They need to outlaw that.
Sheamus, man, with a clothesline. Sheamus in a tweet earlier today said, these guys better be brave souls because the mood I'm in, they don't want to climb into the chamber with me and see what he's talking about.
Yeah. Suplex Cesaro back into the ring.
Cesaro sitting down on Sheamus there. Going to
can you imagine? Could you imagine if Cesaro suplex Sheamus out onto that steel floor?
We know he can. We know how strong Cesaro is. Cesaro again with a block.
He's trying.
And look at this.
Oh, yeah.
Sheamus counter coming over the top rope. Now both men outside on that steel right in front of Randy Orton. Oh, right into the post.
Is that a smirk on the face of Orton in there?
I hope these guys beat the heck out of each other. Oh, and right to the midsection.
We knew it was going to be physical between these two.
John, how did the light bulb go on for Cesaro? How has he been on such a roll lately?
I think a lot of it has to do with Zeb Coulter.
Watch this. Right to the gut. Oh! Meanwhile, top of the left-hand part of your screen, kick out by Sheamus.
We saw the greatness in Cesaro from the moment he walked into WWE, from the moment he walked into NXT. It just took a little refining. It took a coach like Zeb Coulter to take Cesaro to where he is right now and to where he could go tonight.
Now a battle in front of John Cena, who's now Cesaro mocking Cena. I don't know why that is.
Look at these double uppercuts.
Come on, fella!
Sheamus, who loves to fight, and he wants to go toe-to-toe with Cesaro. Oh, and an uppercut, flooring Sheamus.
Sheamus was trying to deliver one himself. Cesaro got the best of that exchange. Oh!
Two of the most physical. Look at Sheamus. End up to the top rope now. And Cesaro again with an uppercut.
Everything with Cesaro is straight ahead.
Cesaro said when he wins this match,
relentless.
Tonight, he's going to be the new face of the WWE and the new face of America. As we await the first entry in this match for the pod.
I mean, Zeb will be one of the faces of WWE.
Look at this!
Sam Sheamus shoulder tackle. Who's going to enter the chamber next? It is Daniel Bryan.
Oh my!
And here comes Bryan. The WWE fans exploding.
He's flying.
The missile drop kick. But remember, Daniel Bryan's got a bad shoulder, and that adrenaline will cover that up for only a little bit of time here. Into the midsection. And it's got to be so hard, John, when you come flying out of that chamber, not to burn out all your energy too quick.
Absolutely. It's a very similar strategy to the Royal Rumble. You've got to be there at the end to win this thing.
Yeah, it's the last elimination that counts.
You can eliminate everybody up till then and get eliminated yourself and not win.
Daniel Bryan to Sheamus now, and to Cesaro. Sheamus and Cesaro started this match. Bryan, the fresh man, at this moment.
Daniel Bryan dishing out some punishment.
Thank God he only has 2 feet.
Imagine if he were an octopus.
Well, usually at this point he goes for the roundhouse kick, but nobody's ready for it. Now Cesaro is! Cesaro should have stayed down. It's Cesaro rolling under the bottom rope.
Smart move by Cesaro.
And now Sheamus. I think he went right to the shoulder, didn't he?
I don't think so. I think he got him in the midsection, but he may have been aiming for that shoulder.
Daniel Bryan from behind. Nice drop toe hold. On Sheamus. Remember, submission maneuvers count here, guys. You tap out, you head to the locker room. Listen to the crowd.
Watch it.
Cesaro. Man, look at that. He's got one man in a submission hold, the other covered.
Cesaro's making a mistake here.
And shoulders down again.
I'm not sure why Cesaro would break up a submission move.
Yeah, you're right. It's in Cesaro's best interest for anybody else to get eliminated.
I know it's a natural tendency, and that's what happens in the heat of battle. But
again,
that's where experience comes. You know, Daniel Bryan won this thing in 2012.
You want eliminations?
Uh-oh.
Nice tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Isn't enough to put Bryan away and burst? Oh, no, and a kick out. Again, you remember, it's every man for himself, but every elimination counts. It doesn't matter if you get the eliminations, as long as you're in the match when the final two are in the ring. Now Sheamus goes right back to work on Cesaro.
I think he's saying, hey, fella, this is what those uppercuts feel like. Oh, that's what a big clothesline from the Celtic Warrior feels like.
Those unique matches.
Cesaro, just when you think you got him stopped, he's not even slowed down.
You're right, King, he's relentless.
You know, Sheamus, he landed hard on that steel. You saw him grabbing the back of his leg, the hamstring area.
Look at this. Cesaro.
Oh, now Bryan with an uppercut. And now Cesaro bounced off the steel.
Wow.
Oh, Bryan, he went right through the pod.
Oh, man, he broke it.
Cut his face.
Daniel Bryan
sent
right through the pod. But, guys, the situation is the bad shoulder. Daniel Bryan hit the pod head. Shoulder first.
Yeah, he tried to.
Wow, is this dangerous?
Watch this.
That's an instinct to try to block your shoulder.
And again, Daniel Bryan coming into this match just beaten up. Shoulder attack by Christian caused the initial damage. And then Kane. And Cesaro goes to work on Sheamus. And now the uppercuts. There's yet to be elimination yet in this match. Oh, and he's not going to try this on the steel, is he? There he is! Oh, my Lord!
Oh, man! Get him in the ring. I think you can pin him right now.
Sheamus dragging Cesaro, or at least attempting to, back into the ring. Watch this.
Watch this, man. This is throwing caution to the wind.
Cover by Sheamus. Kick out at two.
This is what I mean by luck of the draw. These other three guys are still in their pod as fresh as they can be.
These guys are getting beat to hell, the ones that are right there in the middle of this. To your point earlier, though, John, I saw Cena shadow boxing, dancing around over there, trying to stay loose, trying to stay ready. He don't know when he's going to be in. He could be next.
The last thing you want to do is go out there when you're cold, like you know, King, against a guy that's fresh, against a guy that is warmed up.
Sheamus is going up top as we await the next entry in the chamber.
Who's it gonna be?
Here comes Christian.
Whoa!
And Christian quickly into this match. Captain Charisma hoping to pick up the first elimination. And look at Christian, he's smart here. It was Christian who caused the initial shoulder injury on Daniel Bryan last Monday night. He's targeting the shoulder again.
So guys, what we're witnessing here is a triple threat that just became a fatal four-way.
Indeed. And no eliminations yet inside the chamber.
Pull your shoulder right out of the socket.
Daniel Bryan landing on the steel. Christian, who's just been a different man, different attitude lately. Oh, and again to the shoulder. Former world champion, feeling the pressure, realizing that the time's now. May never get another opportunity at a championship. Now trying to rip apart that protective covering.
This is a vicious Christian right here.
I like this Christian.
Desperate equals dangerous, according to Christian.
You better be dangerous if you're in this match.
Oh, man.
Oh, come on now.
Using the pod to his advantage.
Hey, it's all legal, King.
Christian measuring his man.
Yeah, he's just waiting for Daniel to get up.
Oh, with the back shoulder. Oh, again. Is it enough to put Daniel Bryan away and eliminate him in a kick out of two? John, you've been in the position Christian's in, nearing the end of your career, injury starting to mount, not knowing when you're going to get a title match again. How desperate is he?
You've got to take advantage of what the championship matches you have left, and you don't know when your last one is going to be. Everybody wants one more run. Everybody wants that one more match. This could be Christian's last. He doesn't know. He's got to take advantage of it.
You see Orton glaring from that pod that he's in. Wondering, is he going to be next?
Going to be Orton. Seen only two men remain as Bryan again lands on his shoulder. Sheamus and Cesaro. Finally, Sheamus back to his feet. And now for a while now, Christian going to feel the wrath of the Celtic Warrior. Friday night on SmackDown, these two were engaged in a hellacious match. And don't think Sheamus. Christian.
Really saved himself right there. It's gonna be a long dart right into that pod.
Uh-oh, now Cesaro.
Oh no. Can you imagine if Cesaro starts that swing and it ends up with somebody's head in that chamber?
Christian going for that kill switch. Well, that's still great.
Oh, and Christian! Nice! Cesaro, baby, goes for the uppercut. Christian hung out of the chamber. Uh-oh, now he's in trouble. Oh, my God! Oh.
Man. And around.
Here's the cover by Cesaro. And a kick out by Christian.
Man, that had to rattle Christian all the way down to his boots.
There's the damage that's been done to the pod. And you guys, two men remain to be released into this chamber match, and we have yet to have an elimination.
Yeah, these two guys that are still in the pod, Randy Orton and John Cena, would love to see a couple of these guys eliminated before they have to get out of that pod.
Orton's getting ready, Cena's getting ready. The battle continues between Cesaro, Sheamus, Ryan, and Christian. Off the pod when Bryan went through it.
These two, I'm telling you, there's some bad blood between these two.
Oh man, on the steal again. Remember, Sheamus is just a month removed from his return from shoulder surgery.
I don't care if you got healthy shoulders, that hurts.
Well, You said it many times leading up to tonight, JBL. Everything in this match hurts.
Yes, it
and
does.
Who is next to enter the chamber? In the background, he's the champ. He hasn't been in the match yet.
Now I would say that is a distinct advantage for Randy Orton.
And Christian going for the kill switch.
He got it.
And he connects. Christian, is he going to eliminate Brian here? Stays in it.
Christian was hurt. Terrible cover by Christian, but he did the best he could. I think if he could have hooked that leg and got Daniel Bryan tight, he'd have beat him.
Gone from a fatal four-way to a, what do you call it, five-way here.
We're about to have a Canadian long dart launched.
Cena! Woo! Christian launch!
Did you see that?
How the hell did that happen?
Cena now planting Christian.
John Cena. Still fairly fresh. Oh, look at it!
Sheamus would see it up top. White noise! That's how he defeated Christian on Friday! Is it enough? Cena kicks out!
Well, I said Cena was fairly fresh, but that white noise took a lot of wind out of his sails.
One man enter. That's Randy Orton. No one eliminated yet as the Elimination Chamber for the WWE World title rolls on.
I love these two with those uppercuts.
They started the match, and they're still going at it. Section. Cesaro here, going for the neutralizer. Cesaro on the counter by Sheamus. Christian dumps Sheamus now.
Man, oh man. This is fast and furious action right here.
Christian tornado DDT, landing Cesaro. Is it enough? First elimination of the night. Will it be Cesaro? Will Christian do it? Cesaro kicks out at 2.5.
As we call Christian the desperate underdog. But so far, he is hanging with everybody, showing his stuff.
He's a former world champion. He certainly has the ability to
avoid elimination. Oh, man. And avoid the chamber.
It's just the odds against any person winning. They're against all of them.
Cena with a shoulder tackle. Oh, an uppercut. Caught him right on the chin. He caught him on the chin. Cena may be out. Cena kicks out on instinct. I thought Cena was out. He caught him flush on the jaw.
That was an awesome move. And, Cesaro got some pretty impressive traps there, too. But that was an awesome move.
Watch Cena's chin. Watch his chin right here. Watch the contact by Cesaro to Cena. Driving his head, snapping his neck back. And Cena manages to end it.
Cena kicked out on pure instinct. I don't think he has any idea where he's at.
I believe you're right. Guys, this has got to be to great advantage for the champion, Randy Orton.
Yeah, Orton's gonna enter this chamber sometime very soon.
He's gonna be able to take his pick as who he wants to pick off, I think. Because they're just hammering each other.
Just beating the heck out of each other. Feet and hands and arms and legs. Cena, now Daniel Bryan, I mean, there's people going everywhere. Bryan now at Cena, Cena's down, now Bryan hit Cesaro. Bryan's hitting anything that moves.
And I understand it's the heat of the battle, but Daniel Bryan makes a mistake there. Let Cena hit Cesaro with whatever he's gonna hit him with.
Yeah, you gotta see, they gotta let people eliminate people here.
Guys, how big are the stakes?
Man, I think Bryan ran into the post.
How big are the stakes that no one so far has suffered elimination?
Yeah, and the champion is about to enter this match. It's very, very soon. The WWE's apex predator lying in wait.
Champion's about the only one standing. It's only because he hadn't gotten the match yet.
Yeah. We have seen some definite punishment dished out and are about to see
look
some
at
more.
This.
Oh, man!
It's unworldly.
Can Cesaro eliminate Sheamus? The cover by Cesaro and a kick out. You notice how Cena did not try to knock Cesaro off the cover there. Smart move by Cena.
Veteran move, his fifth elimination chamber.
And here comes the champion Orton. All five men are down. Randy Orton can pick and choose who he wants to go after. First Cesaro, now Cena. Now stop me to Sheamus. And now Daniel Bryan.
JBL, do you agree with this strategy, or should he just single out one opponent and go after him until he finishes him off and then go to somebody else?
I agree with the latter, King. I think he needs to single somebody out and try to beat him. You can't whoop them all. Single them out and beat one at a time.
You can't beat anybody standing there looking at the crowd. Oh, my gosh. Wow. What an ego. It needs its own zip code.
He's the self-proclaimed voice of the WWE. He believes he's going to WrestleMania. But in order to get there, five men have got to be eliminated. We have not had an elimination yet in this match. Going for the punt, Daniel Bryan. Drawn out of harm's way, and now everyone has the champion cornered.
Oh, boy.
That answers your question about strategy, King.
The champion is a marked man. No place for Randy Orton to run except trying to lock himself back in the pod.
Well, they used to say you can't go home again, but Randy Orton's trying.
Sheamus squaring off with Orton as the other four men.
That's great
back
strategy.
To doing battle.
Crazy.
He's outsmarted Sheamus.
He has. See what he's going to do.
Oh, my God. Broke kick! Broke kick! A broke kick through the pod! And Orton's down! And Sheamus looks to take advantage! Sheamus just broke kicked the hell out of the pod!
And now he's beat the hell out of Randy Orton!
And Sheamus dropping Orton into the chamber! Measuring Randy Orton, how sweet this would be for John Cena.
Put
Cesaro from behind, and there goes Cena. Now Cesaro, he's beaten Orton once before. He's looking to do it again. Cesaro going for the swing.
Oh, he's not going to swing the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, is he?
Oh, he's swinging. Just a swinging.
He's swinging so much, the Ace Cowboy's getting busy. When's he gonna stop?
Even Zip's dizzy over there.
Cesaro's going for 30.
Oh my God.
30 rotations. He's in it. And now Daniel Bryan trying to take advantage of a dizzy Cesaro. Oh man,
what a throw. But Cesaro still with the wear about to get himself out of the ring.
Guys, we still do not have anyone eliminated. Christian planted by Sheamus. Watch this.
Watch out. Randy Orton got back into this elimination chamber match. Courtesy of that broke kick.
Can you believe all six men are still in this match?
It's amazing.
Everyone's been released from the pod. Sheamus and Cesaro started this thing for the WWE World Heavyweight title. Sheamus broke kick out. He caught Cena flush. Sheamus and Sheamus kicked out. Now trying to get Cena. Cena who ran into the probe. And Cena kicked out.
Man.
Don't forget. And Sheamus has it. That Christian knocked Sheamus off the top rope at the end of SmackDown this past Friday. Sheamus hasn't forgotten about it.
This could Christian.
Oh my God, look at Sheamus with Christian up high here.
Oh, and not on the floor.
And Christian gonna climb out of the top of the pod.
Looks like a little Canadian monkey.
Like a little spider monkey. But he's not gonna be able to hide from Sheamus.
And now Orton and Orton. Three men up there high.
Way up there.
Yes, they are.
Oh, no!
Christian on top of the pod. A splash to Sheamus from the top of the pod by Christian. That's why he says desperation equals dangerous. Christian looking to eliminate Sheamus. First elimination of the match could be coming, and he got it. Christian eliminated Sheamus.
Sheamus has been eliminated.
Oh, my God.
That's a huge elimination.
Watch this one more time. Look at the top of your, bottom of your screen. Look at Christian flying from the top of the cage. Wow.
So five men remain. Sheamus has to leave the chamber now after the elimination. We're down to Cesaro, Cena, Orton, Christian, Bryan.
What a great effort by the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus.
One of the five men remaining is going to be WWE World Heavyweight Champion and headline WrestleMania. As the doctors and trainers now aid Sheamus out of the chamber. Sheamus lasted 26 minutes. He was the first guy in. Exploding.
He covered that
Christian.
Knee.
And there goes Christian. DB eliminates Christian with a knee.
Christian has been eliminated.
So just like that, two men eliminated. We're down to four. Cesaro, Orton, Cena, Bryan.
And oh man, tough luck for Christian. He had to be feeling good about himself after coming off the top of that chamber and eliminating Sheamus. But he doesn't feel too good about himself right now. That knee by Daniel Bryan took him right out of the chamber match.
Valiant effort by Captain Charisma, though. We're down to the final four. One of these guys is going to WrestleMania. One of these guys is going to be the WWE World Heavyweight Champion tonight.
Three more eliminations must happen before that happens.
Well, we're back to a fatal four-way. Look at all these superstars eyeing each other.
A title that was 50 years in the making is at stake.
One of these men's going to be the undisputed champion, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Bryan and Orton. Cena and Cesaro. Oh, Cesaro bounced off the steel. A failure. Orton bounced off the steel and the pod.
Now it's Cena and Daniel Bryan eyeing each other.
Hey guys, this is where this journey really started for Daniel Bryan. All the way back at SummerSlam versus John Cena for the WWE title. The night he beat Cena. The night that Triple H stabbed him in the back and allowed Orton to become champion. That's where it all started for Bryan. And now Bryan and Cena battling out here 6 weeks away from WrestleMania in both men's dream. Daniel Bryan going for the S-lock, going for the submission maneuver on John Cena, trying to get the S-lock locked in on Cena. And Cena able to power through it.
Oh, no.
Going to the AA on Daniel Bryan. Cesaro, you got to be kidding me.
Did you see that?
You want to talk about power. Cover on John Cena, kick out.
That is unbelievable. What a German suplex.
There goes Orton.
That was the weight of Otto Von's. He just suplexed.
Drop toe hold by Cena. Now Cena perhaps going to try to put Cesaro in position for the STF. Cesaro able to counter on his own.
He's
Cesaro.
Relentless. Cesaro is relentless.
He had a great match with Cena Monday. There's the gut wrench. Cena countered though.
Incredible move by John Cena.
And now with Cesaro up on his shoulder going for the AA here. Cesaro hanging on.
No. He's done for.
And now Cena trying to drag Cesaro back into the ring and take advantage. Cena into the STF. Locks it in. Submission maneuver. Cesaro taps. Will be down to three.
My gosh.
Cesaro has been eliminated.
Cesaro tapped out. Couldn't quite see it from our angle, but Cesaro taps out to the STF. Great showing, though, by Cesaro.
But what a brutal elimination that was.
So, guys, we've got three men left now. It's down to Daniel Bryan, Randy Orton, and John Cena. One of these three men's going to headline WrestleMania as the WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
And you see the bad luck of the draw. Cesaro and Sheamus both started this match, both eliminated.
Randy Orton went for the RKO. John Cena countered. John Cena dropped toe hold. John Cena going for the STF now. The STF locked in on Orton. Is Randy Orton going to tap? Is Orton going to tap? Destroying Cena, the Wyatt family, who beat the Shield earlier tonight, are making their presence felt again. Oh my God, Sister Abigail. Family doing out here.
How did they get inside the chamber?
The Wyatts have left John Cena helpless. They appeared at the Royal Rumble match with Cena and Orton. They've appeared again here tonight in Elimination Chamber.
Look at this.
And
look
Randy Orton,
this
is brilliant. His time.
This is brilliant.
He's
going to
send it into the cover.
Brilliant.
He's going to hook the leg and he's going to eliminate John
brilliant.
Cena. And we're
John
now down
Cena
to Orton
has
and Bryan.
Been eliminated.
John Cena's WrestleMania dream is over, thanks to the Wyatt family. This is just a startling
get the Wyatts out of here.
Turn of events.
They'll come back. They're gonna come back if you don't get them out.
Oh, wait,
here.
Wait, wait. There's Kane, the director of operations.
Get these boys out of here. Get out of here. Get to the back now.
Actually, applaud Kane here for coming out and trying to rectify what's just been an awful situation. And the Wyatts had no business. I mean, there's no disqualification, Elimination Chamber match. I get that, but they had absolutely no reason to come out here tonight. Officer, the doctor, the trainer, still checking on John Cena, who's beaten up pretty good by. Wait a minute, Daniel Bryan! Daniel Bryan with a knee to the side of the head of Kane, and now Randy Orton attacking Bryan and sent him into the pod.
Oh no!
And now Daniel Bryan top rope Randy Orton now.
Look at this!
And Daniel Bryan slides underneath Orton, gets caught up on the top. What's Bryan going to do here to Orton? One of these two men is going to WrestleMania. It's either going to be Daniel Bryan or Randy Orton. And it might be Daniel Bryan if he keeps this up.
It's looking good for Daniel Bryan right now. He's got Orton in big time trouble.
And Daniel Bryan right to Orton again. And Randy Orton, his championship reign may be closing in on an end. Daniel Bryan is close here.
Can Daniel Bryan finally do it?
Can Daniel Bryan realize his dream?
I'd say his left arm is almost useless, but he needs to keep using those feet.
Yeah, but adrenaline here from this capacity crowd, sold-out crowd here in Minneapolis tonight.
Oh!
Side suplex to Orton from the top rope. Can Daniel Bryan capitalize? Bryan, can he eliminate Randy Orton here? Is Daniel Bryan going to WrestleMania? Here's the cover on Orton and a kick out by the champion.
Man. So close.
The WWE World Heavyweight Championship at stake.
Daniel Bryan is, and I don't know what you can think of that you haven't already done or had done to you in this match.
Daniel Bryan with that protective bandage hanging out, and Randy Orton, the shrewd viper.
Uh-oh.
And Orton's got it by the beard. And now Daniel Bryan from the second rope. Randy Orton looking to put him away with a DDT.
What is that? Vintage Orton.
And now Randy Orton believes that he's going to be the man. Face of the WWE, heading to New Orleans at WrestleMania with the RKO. Daniel Bryan countered. Daniel Bryan out of the corner. He got him with a knee. Bryan got him with a knee. Daniel Bryan got him with a knee.
Gonna do
Bryan's
covering.
Going to WrestleMania. Bryan hooks the leg. There's the two count.
Wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Oh, come on. Kane grabbed the official. Kane grabbed the official.
Come on,
Bryan
count.
Was going for the win.
Count again.
Oh, Kane had left the ring.
He's attacked by Daniel Bryan for no reason.
And already over the RKO from behind. Not this way. Damn it. Not this way. A kick out by Bryan.
Oh, my gosh.
Daniel Bryan's got a chance. Daniel Bryan's still breathing. Listen to this place.
Every single person in here is chanting yes.
Randy Orton's throwing a fit. Daniel Bryan's wrapped him up. Shoulders down. Movement spurring him on. Daniel Bryan wants to headline WrestleMania, a lifelong dream.
Become the second ever WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
Kane, oh my, Kane again, and now an RKO. Off that cheap shot, that blind shot by Kane. Daniel Bryan is screwed again.
The winner of this match, and still WWE World Heavyweight Champion, the Viper, Randy Orton.
An absolutely blatant, disgusting abuse of power by the director of operations.
Daniel Bryan should have never attacked Kane. He was out here just to help control things. He got the Wyatt family out of here. He was tending to John Cena, and Daniel Bryan, the insubordinate employee, attacked an officer of the company.
Okay, that's the way you see it.
Randy Orton retains the WWE World Heavyweight Championship.